Hi, good morning. So we're back on Planet Toulan. Of course, we're doing the Nadira's attempt 1000 daily attempt. It's any blueprint you want to choose. The one we're going with is the EP1 because we're demonstrating how cheaply you can do this. It allows you to gain 70 PEC in machinery skill. And if you're an item crafter, of course, you know machinery does make up in the 5%-ish area of a large amount of the different item crafting. And so that 70 pack daily does add up. Over the 30 days that we're doing it, of course, we'll end up getting a entire 21 ped in skills. Honestly, if you think about how valuable that is in trade terminal value in an auction house, it's pretty valuable. We're not going to auction out the skills, honestly. We need them. It's going to backfill and rebalance this character a lot. So, to go over everything like normal, we'll have this set up so it'll show everything as it progresses. Of course, we do have a whole bunch of sunjot leather for the runs after we're done with this 30-day run. We'll get back to the tooling and texturing chronicles thing. The blueprint I'm going to be using today is a 100% blueprint. Obviously, it's been developed. This guy is absolutely qualified to do this because they're very engineering, very mechanically, and I am a get over here, boom, 46 level mechanical engineer. And so, results could vary depending on your skill levels and how well you've backfilled what you've backfilled. When it starts running, of course, I'm going to get my face out of the way. So I'm not just sitting here looking at it. In all honesty, though, if anything occurs, a blueprint pop or anything, I'm going to discuss it. At the end, we'll look at the overall, hey, what we got up or down. And good morning, is that corpse with a five, or am I misunderstanding the name? Everybody's computer names are complex, confuse me sometimes. With a K too. So we got welding wire blueprint right off the bat. That's 84 pack worth. I would say within that short of a run span, that's a really good sign. This really looks like it's up on the overall markup. It was down for a while. I saw that some of that's looking like a 10% sellout rate. I would consider 10% markup over a little bit high. So that's good to see. Okay, that's good to know. I didn't want to be mispronouncing people's names. And everybody has spelt things in interesting ways on the internet. So you have to like actually double check that you think you know what they're saying. Because sometimes people are saying some things that you're not really aware of. And you're like, so what will happen is, if anything does occur, it'll help us. I think we're going to actually break even if it can stay as awesome as that was right off the bat. If we're able to get the explosive projectile recycler blueprint, those have such a ridiculously high markup that those will carry this entire clicky-click run on their own. And so, all in all, this will run through. I'm going to find out what we finished out the other day at real quick because I would like to know. I don't remember, honestly, and I hate to misquote where we're at in the overall up-down of this run. I think we're at 2.1, but let me check real quick. Yeah, we're down 2.1 right now as it sets. Which honestly, if you think about the fact we're at run number 8, 2.1 is not bad. I'm gonna write that down so that we have that for later. I honestly don't know. We could be up, we could be down on this run. We have considerable skill. So anything more than 5% down bugs me. I shouldn't be shocked at anything in the 5% down range. I still don't have the industrialist skill unlocked. And so that's gonna be a missing component of success, right? Well, I'm gonna let this go. I'm gonna zap my face out of the way, and basically, I'm only gonna say something if something happens, so I'm not just bugging you guys the whole day. By the way, good morning. be honest. A little shocked we haven't got another blueprint, but we've had good days and bad days on this one. Like, some days we get six, some days we get, like, two. Very, very, very random. Let's hope for an explosive projectile recycler. That makes it all worth it. And let's hope for a couple things that are less than super rare, but common-ish, so we can throw them for cheap into the auction house. Hook some people up. Okay, so this basic auxiliary socket, I don't believe they have a good value on them, but I'm going to let you guys know, I have used the crap out of this. I have ran these so many times. So, it's listerium and oil. This legitimately is one of the cheapest electronics engineering blueprints you can run. I honestly don't know how it's not more valuable. It pops a whole bunch of blueprints. I get a lot of people aren't electronic engineering people. Electronic components go in a really lot of stuff. I mean, I'm not super high electronic engineering. I mean, I am-ish, depending on who you're looking at. But in all honesty, if I didn't have some electronic engineering, I wouldn't even be able to make some of the items I make because I couldn't find the subcomponents for it. And so, let's just be honest. It's really, really hard to find subcomponents for certain things. And sometimes you find them and you're like, oh my God, they want to charge me 100% markup. And you know that you can't manufacture anything at the markups that they're asking for some of the subcomponent like things that you need. And I'm not trying to be complaining about it, but realistically, like if you're going to be making stuff and loading it to the auction at a competitive price, you either have to find a really high quality outsourcing option where they're providing it a low markup that's within reason. Or you have to decide, hey, what do I have to do? So we're at the 500 mark. I would have expected that we would have had more blueprints than two. But the relative, hey, that looks good. This looks good. That, I'm going to load for one ped into the auction house for a buyout. Secretly, I'm also going to load a tab blueprint for one ped too. Just as a hooking up thing, but I'll have to grab that out of storage, you know what I mean? I have extra blueprints in storage for bonus stuff. Planning ahead. Thank you. Okay, so the basic filter, we all know that's a junk blueprint, pretty much. Everybody that already has one. I'm not even sure that this might actually be the trade terminal thing. I'd have to look. I mean, this, I don't remember what the default first blueprint for mechanics is, but I know everybody and their dog has a basic filter blueprint. Is a good blueprint for running just to pop some other stuff, though, just for the record. that sound always makes me excited, even if I'm not the one getting it. But congrats to them, so we're gonna say that. Who doesn't like getting it? It's like the most exciting thing, you know what I mean? Well, an HOF is the most exciting thing. That's a jaw dropper, you know what I mean? But I'll take a global any freaking day. I'll take a global for somebody else any day, actually. You know that just made their whatever minutes there good. Okay, so I'm gonna be honest. I think we're kicking some butt. I don't know exactly. We didn't get the amount of blueprints I would have thought, right? But from past experience, we know that that's in the zone of maybe less than a 10% down. I mean, I'm not gonna guess right this second. Well, I guess I am guessing right this second. What I'm starting to believe, you know, I need to have more runs, honestly, to be able to know for sure. But, this, I believe if we were at 2 ped in residue with about this much in blueprint value, I think we would be broke even on this. So I'm going to guess probably that we're about a pet down, which is 5%. That's actually not a big deal. We'll wait and see. I'm pretty sure it's in that zone though. Which honestly for the overall run puts us really kicking some butt, you guys. I was expecting 5 to 10% down daily. And so the fact that we're actually pulling where we are has not been a bad thing. The thing is, we really started off strong with a high-hitting first run. And so overall, we have not been ahead on every run, you know what I'm saying? We're down 201 full run through right now, though. I am gonna load this. I don't know if this will get bought out of the auction, but I hope that if somebody is doing this kind of stuff where they're electronic engineering, they do buy this. It absolutely spawns the crap out of a ton of blueprints. It only takes listerium and oil. This filter blueprint, I know it's the same exact stuff. It does pop a whole bunch of stuff. I actually think that these pop too commonly and everybody has one. I'm actually not sure that the filter's not the base blueprint that they give you in the little technician, to be honest. I don't remember. It's been so freaking long ago. I have maxed out one of these and have one almost like 60%, because this can go into two different books. So weirdly enough, I have it in two books. I don't know why. I think I need maxed versions in both books. Okay, final 10. So we're also going to throw in that extra bonus blueprint, just so you guys know. Being wild. It's actually not wild. But it's really hard to like reward people with the blueprints that are generated from this type of thing. And I do like to be able to have some kind of actual reward. So let's check these real quick because this is always important. So that isn't super high, you know what I mean? Oh, really close. I was off by 6 PEC. So we lost 1.06. So slightly, barely over 5%. I mean, and that is barely. Bringing this total runs cost to 3.07 PET. That's pretty awesome, actually. I mean, the total of all these together has combined to that. Okay, I'm going to click out on this. We're going to pop into here. Sorry. We're going to go down to where we have backup blueprints for stuff. Okay, so I believe it's the d'Or that's right out of the gate. And I'm going to try to find a tab for us. So those two blueprints are going to go into the auction house right now. I know. Oh wait, that's not the auction house, guys. Whoa. I ran way too far there, guys. Looks like we have a bunch of stuff in there. Because we do. I don't really think that these are the greatest thing to throw on this planet. And so I might actually even stop throwing those. I know that's below markup. You would think that that would be a incentive. This tab right now is definitely going to indicate below markup. And so shall this. So this should help somebody get started on their little boom. You would think, right? And then so just like that, we have successfully kicked butt and we're about to gain another 70 pack in machinery. And so just the reality that you can just rack this machinery up like that, boom. Look at that. We're flying up levels and stuff with this. I'm gonna just say that is epic as crap. So I do hope one of you guys grabs those blueprints real quick. They're actually for sure more valuable than what we just threw them in there. So that should benefit you guys. I hope you have a great day. Peace and very best wishes. I will be back on later today, shooty stuff, and probably exploring for resources and explaining some backfilling of skills, to be honest, too. Plus, extra thingy-majiggy there, too. Peace. Very best wishes, and I hope you guys have a great day.